So welcome back to Forex Pros. Today we will be discussing multi-time frame analysis on gold and see what kind of trading opportunities can we find in the current market. So starting from the monthly time frame, what we can see is that this is a very important structural resistance which has been broken by the monthly time frame, monthly candle, and the monthly candle has closed below this, and we can expect the market to continue its movement towards the downside. Also, this kind of candle, when the body wick is greater than the body, then we expect the next few candles to cover the wick. So in the long run, on the basis of monthly time frame, we can expect the market to go down to 1680 before continuing its movement towards the upward direction. And if the market starts to move in the upper direction, the monthly time frame, we can expect the drop to 1560 or 1570. That is in the long run. So now moving down to the weekly time frame, what we can see is that similarly on the weekly time frame, the situation is very simple. This was a structure support at this point, which this was an effective structure support, again a structure effective structure support, and now at this point the market has broken below and retesting the structure support at this point. So on the weekly time frame, the market is expected to be bearish as well. So on the basis of monthly and weekly, we can expect the market to go down in the sell position. Now on the daily time frame, this situation is slightly different because this is the structure which is very important, because this was structure support at this point, resistance at this point, again support at this point, and again we are expecting a support at this point. So in the short term, on daily time frame, we can expect the market to reject the structure support and continue its movement towards the upward direction. So if for the swing traders, what I recommend is that they monitor the price action of the market on the 4-hour chart, and if they see that the market is shifting its momentum towards the upper direction, they take a buy entry from this point. Otherwise, what they could do is wait for the market to break below the structure support, and then on the retest they can monitor the price action of the market on the 4-hour chart to get the confirmed entry and have a good bearish movement. Now a lot of people were asking that I should upload my analysis for scalpers and day traders as well. So moving down on the 4-hour time frame, what is the current situation? So the current situation is that this is the structure resistance which is of much importance at this point. Also, one thing which I need to do is that let me plot the structure resistance at this point and structure support at this point. So basically what the market is doing at the moment is stuck in between these structures. So what we can see is that market did make a fake breakout, but currently the market is in between in these positions. So before we expect the market to continue its movement towards the downside, what my thought is that, as we can see, this candle indicates a strong rejection to the upside. So when the market opens tomorrow, we can expect the market to go up to 1765, and I have also given a signal, but we closed half lots and sell at 1760 and got 50 pips. This was the first day of the market, and when the market opens, first and last day is not the preferable or recommended day for trading. So basically from tomorrow, what we'll be expecting the market to go up to 1765, and from that point we can have a good sell entry up to 1724. So for scalpers or day traders, this is a good entry point which they could use. And if you liked our analysis, do like the video and tell us in the comment section which pair or topic would you like us to analyze in the next video. And don't forget to press the subscribe button and the bell icon button so you could get the updates of any video, any analysis that we upload. And if you want more signals or account management service, the link of our free Telegram channel is in the description.